Friday, November 8th. Here at Boulder, Colorado, the University of Colorado Golden Buffaloes tomorrow will play the wise guys from Stanford. And my lucky jersey will help us, I hope. The overwhelming financial market question this week is, the Fed cut rates last week. Why are they higher now than they've been since July? And before I go into the usual stodgy answers for how this can be so, I've learned of the newest, best put down in the society, which is, okay, boomer. Somebody asked a perfectly good question, and the baby boomer in question gives some stodgy, down-the-nose, superior answer. And the millennial response is, okay, boomer. So if I get emails after this that just say, okay, boomer, I'll understand. How can rates be higher now than they were before the Fed cut, and higher than any time since summer? Start with the Fed. The Fed controls the overnight cost of money. The Fed, only twice in its 100-year history, has set out to control mortgage rates directly. That was during World War II, until Korea, and in the aftermath of Lehman from 2008 to 2013. Other than that, the Fed moves short-term rates and markets move long-term ones. And long-term investors, the people who buy mortgages, think long-term. Okay, boomer. The long-term world changed during the year this year. A year ago, right now, mortgage rates were 5.25. We are today about 4.25. The Fed created the misimpression that it intended to raise its cost of money all year, open-ended. And it quickly realized a year ago December, that the markets had misunderstood, it had misspoken. And so rates started to come down a year ago. And they came down in addition, having nothing to do with the Fed because of a trade war, which trade wars have the capacity to create a global recession. And that fear began to rise during the springtime. The Fed said it would be patient, canceled the fear that it was going to continue to hike. And early summer, the trade war intensified. The Fed switched to cutting. Its first cut was on July 31st. It gave the impression that that was it, taking out a little insurance policy against what could happen. The next day, August 1st, was a tariff trade spasm from the White House, and mortgage rates and other long-term rates fell 0.5% in 2 weeks, fell all the way down to 3.5%. The fear just intensified that the whole world would slow down, and that that slowdown would infect the United States. The Fed has eased two more times since then. In the time that the Fed has cut these three times since summer, it's increasingly clear that the trade war isn't doing as much damage overseas as we feared. And there's practically no damage here in the United States at all. Manufacturing is a small subset of the U.S. economy. 8% of the U.S. workforce is engaged in manufacturing. Farms have felt more pain than maybe anybody else, but again, it's a small set of the economy. The rest of the economy is untouched. The Fed made clear last week that the cut that it did last week was the end. That's it. They feel the policy is well calibrated right now. So we're all going to watch the economy. Not so much the Fed, but the economy itself. Hunches, just plain hunches. There is weakness in the global economy outside the United States that doesn't have anything to do with the trade war. It's different in Japan than it is in China, than it is in Europe. But there's real weakness. Some of it's demographics, aging global population. The United States is slowing down, not because of trade, but the big burst of tax cuts and federal spending in 2017 is now washing out of the economy. As you look at the chart of the Fed's actions over time, they're heavily cyclical. The Fed goes up and it goes down. It doesn't just nibble. The last time it did a mid-course correction was 20 years ago, it was 1998, and it was probably a mistake. I think the odds are still that the Fed's next move will be a cut, and the rise in rates that we have seen in the last few weeks has probably topped. I'm not any good at predicting the future about how far they might go or when, but I wouldn't have any fear that rates are going to spike the way they did a year ago, which really did hurt housing and the economy. How soon they might come down depends on the economy. Good weekend. Go Buffs.